Hello everyone, I am Anindita Patra, health coach at Besugarfit. So how many times before eating a snack do we think and ask, should I? Am I really hungry? Did I exercise today or this week? Or when was the last time we monitor our blood glucose level? Interestingly, we can think of these answers. Why should I? I am just in my 30s or 40s. Do I need to? I don't have any symptoms. Maybe someday I'll exercise when my doctor will tell me. This attitude towards health develops certain behaviors which are not healthy for us. But due to unawareness or non-willingness to become aware, we avoid to listening to health advice or to follow it. Eventually, most of us are at risk of developing this lifestyle disorder that is acting as a sweet poison, killing us inside while we are unaware of it. So how behavior is related to managing prediabetes and diabetes? Diabetes is a lifestyle disorder whose prevalence is increasing with each passing days. It's a metabolic disorder characterized by insulin resistance and increased blood sugar levels beyond the normal range for extended durations. With the modern lifestyle making people more sedentary, less physical active, and more inclined towards junk food, the risk of diabetes has increased multi-folds during the past two decades. Diabetes is also associated with comorbid conditions like obesity, hypertension, etc. The management of diabetes includes the use of anti-diabetic medicine or insulin, as well as behavior modifications. While it is easier to adhere to treatment strategies as prescribed by your physician, behavior modification requires self-determination and motivation for a dedicated regimen to adopt healthy habits. Your healthcare provider can help you explain the benefits of these behavior changes and effective ways to implement them. Research has shown some specific behavior modifications can help you manage your diabetes or prevent you from developing diabetes if you are a pre-diabetic. So let's talk about some of the specific behaviors that help in managing pre-diabetes and diabetes. Point number one, positive attitude. Developing a positive attitude is crucial to start challenging our unhealthy behaviors. Having awareness about our health conditions and developing a positive outlook towards change can help us to adopt easily and stay committed for a longer durations. Telling yourselves, I can, I will, I must, every time I look into the mirror can help you to develop self-belief to achieve the desired blood glucose levels through behavior modifications. Despite the busy schedules, we have to resolve to start with small step and step put. Point number two, self-awareness. Having a sense of self-awareness is critical to assess our health and lifestyle analytically. Listening carefully to health advice, thinking about your health condition, level of activity, calorie intake, monitoring your blood glucose levels, and developing control are a few of the important aspects of self-awareness that can be developed over time with motivation. These days, various web-based and mobile applications are available that we can use to monitor our activity levels and stay aware. Point number three, healthy weight. Maintaining a healthy weight and body mass index is assessed as a crucial step in managing diabetes. While eating something, do we feel I should eat more or I should split and just eat half? This forms the basis to maintain a healthy weight or a healthy waist. Studies have shown that monitoring calorie intake and adapting to a balanced diet have helped people to manage blood glucose levels and diabetes in a better way. We should aim to increase the consumption of whole grains, vegetables, fruits, and to reduce the use of junk and processed foods. Point number four, active lifestyle. To adopt to an active lifestyle, firstly, we need to assess our activity level and our involvement in household activities. We can practice a few of the following. Walking to the grocery shop for weekend shopping, taking the stairs and encouraging our children to do the same. Reading the food labels of food constituents to stay aware of calorie intake and taking small breaks and walking to colleagues if we have a sedentary job. Point number five, make exercise a part of your daily routine. monitoring calorie intake alone is not sufficient to manage diabetes. We should exercise daily to include at least 30 minutes of activity that makes us fit and breathe heavily than usual. If not daily, we should try to have a 5-day regime in a week to attain 2.5 hours of exercise per week. Exercise reduces insulin resistance and helps manage blood glucose levels. Studies have shown that persons who exercise regularly and were eating right could have controlled blood glucose levels and medication load was reduced. To conclude, the modern lifestyle is pushing us towards such behaviors that are easy to follow and require less effort. Contrary to this, we have to stay motivated and adapt to behavior modifications to lead a healthy life. This sense of adapting to new behaviors has to come from within, and we have to become aware of our health and surroundings. First and foremost is the right attitudes to have awareness. This usually comes through self-control, and once the results are visible, the level of commitment increases. To manage diabetes better, we should eat right, exercise regularly, and lead an active life. If not by lips, we should try baby steps to develop healthy habits and lifestyles.